Everyone. Okay, so as you can see, this is going to be my foundation routine. Yes, it's been a long time coming. A lot of people have requested this video for a very long time, and I said, oh, it's coming, it's coming, it's coming. Reason for that. I didn't want to film this video and then everything changed the next week, but then I started to realize, oh, I'm never gonna stop just like buying new things and experimenting with new products and techniques and everything. That's never gonna stop. So I might as well just film this, get it out there, because I've told you so many times that I was going to, and just do it, because you know what? Things are gonna change, but this is my current full-on like flawless face skin routine. Like, it, when I'm like going out, like I'm going out tonight, and like I want to like be like pew, like all of it, like there's a lot of products, a lot of steps, brace yourself. But I mean, this is what it is. Everything could change soon, but you know what, you asked, I'm answering. I will make a product list and put it in the description if you're curious, so you can always pop down in the description. You should anyway on all YouTube videos, because that's just what smart people do. Another thing you need to be ready for, I am only wearing one coat of mascara, and well, my eyelashes are also curled, but one coat of mascara, and you know, I've got my moisturizer on. But so you're about to see me with no makeup, and you better get ready because I'm gorgeous with no makeup. Just kidding. Yeah, anyway, okay, so too much lead up, I'm so sorry. Let's get right into it. Brace yourself. Okay, so here we go. This is the full thing, like just buckle your seatbelts. I'm just kidding. Anyway, on my face right now, I have moisturizer and eye cream and one coat of mascara. I know, I hope you're not too scared.
Sorry.
Anyway, I'm gonna use a primer. I have a lot of different brands of primers. This is the one that I've been really, really, really impressed with, so this is the one I'm gonna use today. It is the Makeup Forever HD High Definition Primer. And I'm just gonna use that all over my face, focusing on the areas where my foundation would tend to settle or crease or rub off. Okay, next up, I am going to use this Eve Pearl Salmon Corrector. It is for under eye discoloration, and I have the light and medium dual corrector, and I'd use kind of a mix of both just on the dark areas under my eye and above my eye, obviously. In case you're wondering about how cool my hair is, oh, thank you. Okay, next step, I'm gonna go in with foundation. I do a lot of times mix this foundation with other things, like I have it in front of me. Yes. A lot of times I like to mix it with the Origins Vitazing, which is awesome, or just a regular moisturizer, or you know, I'm always experimenting. But just to make it simple, I'm just gonna use straight Revlon Colorstay, and this is for normal to dry skin, and it is in number 250 Fresh Beige. I'm just gonna put a little bit of it on the back of my hand, and then I'm gonna apply it with a crown brush, and it's the large duo face brush. It's kind of like a stipple situation, and it's not clean, I'm sorry. But it's okay, it's not your face. And I really like to focus on the areas that I feel actually need foundation, obviously, and try to stay away from the areas that don't particularly need it. That's a no-brainer, right? Okay. I like to blend it on my neck with my hand. Not sure why, that's just what I like to do. I have a little bit of redness and discoloration. It's kind of a special circumstance, I don't think. I mean, I haven't talked about it or anything, but I do like to get some coverage down there. I'm not gonna wear this later, so I do wanna go ahead and try to deal with that. It's probably not the best shirt to wear for my foundation routine video, but oh well. All right, now this step, I'm not sure if it is completely necessary, but it's something I've been liking lately. This is the Real Techniques buffing brush, and I believe it came in a set. Yes, it did. It came in a set, and I just go through and I like gently buff in the foundation. Right, next up, I am going to do a little bit of de-puffing, de-circling, whatever. I'm using the Garnier Nutritionist. I've said that wrong in the past. I'm really glad I learned how to say it. And it's the Skin Renew Anti-Dark Circle Roller, and it does have a little bit of pigmentation. I didn't think I was going to like it, and now I love it. I just mainly put it in those areas that I have the shadow from the puff. I have really huge problems with puffy eyes in the morning, and surprisingly I don't have majorly puffy eyes right now, but I still just love this thing. Put it in my July favorites video after everyone and their dog on YouTube already talked about it. Next, I'm going in with some concealer. This is the Maybelline Mineral Power in Ivory, and it's probably too light for me, but oh well. And I am just putting a little bit of this on the back of my hand. And I'm applying it with my finger. Yes, I said it. I'm applying it with my finger. I have a lot of redness right around my nose. Try to tap that out. A little bit around my mouth. A little bit down my nose. The main thing is this redness around my nose. It's one of my biggest problems. Okay, next up, I take a tissue. And this one has, let me see how many layers. It has 3 layers. And so I peel it apart. And I take just one of the layers. And this is something relatively new, but, well, that was weird. I just press it onto my skin, and it just kind of soaks up any extra moisture that I don't need on my face that's gonna cause like really excessively oily looking grossness later on. And so, I don't know if this is going to work for you. It works for me. It helps set it. I don't rub. I just press. It doesn't take off. I'm not sure if you can see, but like there's almost no color on this. Like it doesn't take off your makeup. It just, I don't know. I really like this step. Of course, if you feel like you've taken off any concealer or, you know, whatever, you can always go back in and touch that up. I've done that in the past, but luckily I don't have to today. Okay, next up, I work on my under eyes just a little bit more. I know. And I'm using the Neutrogena Healthy Skin Brightening Eye Perfector. And this is in number 10 Light. And I click it a couple times. I tap out a little bit on the back of my hand, and what's left on the brush, I dot under my eye. And I kind of focus it right here in this little shape. And then a bit here and here. Down the nose. Okay, and then I just kind of blend, tap all through the eye area. I'm bringing it all the way up. I really hope you can see what I'm doing. Extra on your hand, you can just use it in any area that you feel needs maybe a little bit of highlighting. It doesn't do much. It's not super full coverage or anything. Okay, next up, I'm going to use the Makeup Forever HD powder, and with this I'm going to shake a little bit into the cap, and I'm going to use the Real Techniques brush that is called the pointed foundation brush. It's really small for that, but never used it for foundation, but I'm going to use it for this. I'm using it under the eye to set the foundation, to set the concealer, and even on the eyelid. Some people have problems with this stuff. I personally don't. The whole thing with the flash photography and everything, honestly, I'm okay with it. I still have it, I still like it, and so I'm gonna use it up, you know? I know there are better brands. I've definitely watched videos about it. And I'm also gonna go over all the areas that I used concealer, because I think this sets it really well. It is hot in here. Like, bleh. I feel like this is like defeating the purpose or something. You know what I'm trying to say? Next next step, I'm going to set all the rest of my makeup with the Complexion Perfection Powder by E.L.F. It is 4 different correcting colors, and it's a very light powder. I try to use a really light hand with it because it could give you a little bit of a white cast, but I try to be careful and not have that happen. Yeah, and I don't want to make any kind of cakey look, but I don't think this thing does miracles, but I like it. And it's cheap! And I even go down my neck to help cover up any of that weird discoloration. Okay, it's not that weird. I am a human after all. Next, I'm gonna further brighten my under eyes. I know I'm kind of obsessive about it, but I'm gonna use the Bare Minerals in Well Rested. And I'm applying that with the Crown Brush, the small duo face. So it's a lot like my foundation brush, but it's like way smaller. It's large, this is the small. And I'm just gonna tap a little bit into the cap and then just highlight the area. Definitely very light-handed with this. Or I try to be. And yes, I go over my eyelid as well. Just trying to keep that whole area nice and bright. I kind of brush any excess like around my nose or in any area where I feel like there's still any redness I'm not liking, because it can help with that. I'm sure that's not what you're supposed to use it for, but I do what I want. You know, that's a good thing about makeup. You can kind of just make it work for you however you want to. It's all about experimenting, and it's all about doing what you want to do. Next up, my favorite step ever is bronzer. I know I'm kind of obsessive, and you're gonna see I use it all over my face. I did do my self-tanner last night, and I don't typically put a lot of self-tanner on my face, and so I try to kind of make up for it, and who doesn't like a really tan face? I don't know, it's all like personal opinion. My camera just shut off on me, and I've already done some bronzer, and I was just saying, it's everyone's personal opinion. I really love bronzer. I mean, secret's out. I just love it. I don't know if I included. This is the Physicians Formula Bronzer. It's called Bronze Booster, and it's in medium to dark. And I'm using a Sephora brush, and it is giant and pink. And it is the round powder brush. This was in one of my very first hauls ever. I did that, I think, in that video. Anyway, it was like way back in the day. Yeah, you can watch it if you want. But yeah, giant brush, because I like to use it all over. I try to compensate with bronzer, and yeah, secret's out. Sorry, guys. I think I'm done with bronzer. Bronzer's on. Next up is contouring. Yes, I do both. I'm sorry. I don't play by the rules, but this is just what I do. This is the Crown Brush Mini Bronzer Brush, and it's just like a little flat top guy, very tiny. And this is the L'Oreal True Match Super-Blendable Powder, and it's a neutral shade, and the color is Cappuccino. Cross my forehead, my cheeks a little bit, try to use the edge down the sides of my nose, my chin, the end of my chin just a little bit. Try to make it less pointy. Is that crazy? And then my neck, because I definitely have issues with my neck. But that's another subject. We don't have to talk about it. Lord knows I don't want to. And a little on my ears. Don't judge me. Just try to straighten that out just a little bit. Can't do magic. But you can sure try. I try to focus on the top of the forehead, the chin, and the neck, because like a lot of people try making their face seem like slimmer with contouring, and I don't particularly have that problem because I have a very like slender oval face. It's like very, and I don't particularly like that. I really, really, really admire faces that are more like round and with like big cheeks, and I just love that. Like, I really, really envy people with that face shape. So I try to like shorten mine a little bit. I know I'm completely nuts, but that's what I do. I go in with this brush that I use for my Complexion Perfection and kind of just like blend. My next step that I usually do is blush, and that's something that changes a lot. You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and do it. I hate that this has taken so long for me to get it up, but please forgive me. It happens, you know, I'm so wildly imperfect. Like, you know, I play by my own rules. If, you know, whatever. You guys asked, and I got it to you as fast as I could. I guess that's it. If you have any comments, questions, whatever, just comment down below. You can always find me on Twitter. It's @LeighAnnSays. I'm always there. You can always shoot me questions and I'll get back to you probably a lot faster than if you maybe like send me a question on FormSpring, which I also like that. That's also totally cool. But it's just like if you're in a hurry or something like that. I don't even know. Anyway, yeah, I guess that's it. So thank you so much for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye everyone.